express my love.
Yeah,
I want to express.
Yes, well.
I want to carry my loving wing. The place she loves.
Yeah,
I'm a woman, woman. I want to express. I want to carry my loving wing. The place she loves. After you, after you, after you, yeah, after you, after you, after you, after you, yeah, after you, after you, after you, after you, yeah, after you, after you, after you, after you, yeah, after you,
after you, after you, after you, my body is calling and your body is
calling.
Loving you, they make me forget, say,
I can't let me keep up, I let me go.
Mission, so we've assembled here to receive them and hear their purpose of their visit. So as they are coming, we're going to welcome the guests. From our right hand side here, there come the guests that we're expecting. So I'm going to go to the side there.
Thank you. We are the family of David, and we are here in peace, but since we are outside, we cannot say anything until we are allowed access.
Talking about David, my uncle David, or my brother David?
No, especially David.
We want to know what kind of David is coming to our home. Who is David? David what?
Especially David. David Victory, who is bringing glory into our family.
Amen.
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 David Victory. All right. The family of David Victory, you're most welcome to our humble home. And in this home, you don't just come by just any friend. Right? Somebody has to open the door for you. There is a gate man. Hey, where we come from, you have to give the gate man a chip.
What do you open the door for you?
You have to give the gate man a chip to enter. Did you guys bring a chip for gate man?
Unfortunately, no, because we didn't know this, and this is a surprise to us.
Well,
and
then the gate man cannot open you because that is a requirement. A tip before the gate gets open.
Okay, we will honor it. Please. May I know who you are?
My name is Nanako, the gate man in this house.
And who do you represent?
I represent my uncle William Wallace and the wife, Mrs. Felicity Wallace.
Okay.
Let me see how much you have in your pocket, Mr. Please
We don't accept $1 tips. You know, after COVID, everything has been inflated. Things are so expensive. You can't come here with $1 tip, please. Respect yourself. If you come to our home, you can do better than that if you actually want to come to this home. You know how much you pay for this house?
All right, let me consult, please. Yo. Mr. Richard. So, after consultation, we want to assure you that your tip and anything that you want will be honored. For now, just allow us access and then give us a seat, and we are going to make sure that is sorted out.
That is very welcome. It's Thank acceptable.
You. Thank you.
I'm trusting you on your word, that you honor your word. Please, you are most welcome. And I'm going to welcome with a nice music, which you can shake yourself to know that in this house, we actually day. DJ, give me music to welcome. I couldn't succeed. May I please sit down, please.
Go! Ago. I think we're all Christians. So before we do anything, we have to give all this occasion and everybody to God. So I will ask that we all stand up. So we do something that everybody can, you know, participate. Let's say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Dear Lord, God of heavens, the great and awesome God, who keeps his covenant of love with those who love him and obey his commands. We give you praise, we honor you, we give you thanks, and we say you are the King of kings and the Lord of lords. We thank you and we praise your holy name. Your word says, this is the day the Lord has made. Therefore, we ask you to take absolute control of our doings, and at the end we will rejoice and give you thanks and praise your name through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, so now we can have a seat and let the fun begin.
Thank you. So the family of David, you are most welcome to our humble home. We want to welcome you with water, as our tradition demands. So, if you are thirsty, please feel free and have a drink. See, the gate man said earlier, this home is a very hospitable home. Even though I haven't gotten my tip yet, we welcome you with such a kind gesture, offering you water. That is what we do according to tradition. So after giving you water, the next thing we want to do is to ask you of your mission here. After us, we were informed that you're going to have a guest, and then there's something that you want to see this family about. So that is why we assemble our family and we are here to receive you. So you're most welcome. Is there any good person for you here?
Yeah, we are here. Yeah.
May I know your name, please?
My name is Kojo Thompson.
Mr. Thompson, may I know your relationship with the family?
Oh, David is a handsome man, very kind and great and faithful person. So, as David told me that, you know, things are happening today. And then David walked around this valley and he saw a nice flower. So David wanted to brought this flower. So our question to you is it possible to pluck this flower?
There are so many flowers in our home.
I mean, this one is special.
all the flowers in this room are special.
You know, they are, I mean, blossom. Very dark and beautiful, like it says in the Book of Solomon. So, you know, this flower is one of those lily, you know, in the valley type of flower.
Yes. So
that is very true. You have a lot of beautiful flowers here, but we are working with times and seasons. When the flower is not ready to be plucked, we can't take it. We are here to take the one that is ready, that you know is ready, that we can take home.
All the flowers in this room are ready to be plucked.
Okay.
We will take it in order.
You have the time?
We want the first flower of this house. It is so beautiful and glorious to us that we cannot look and walk away. We want to go home with it.
In this house, we don't differentiate the flowers by first, second, third, fourth. We love all our flowers equally. So I don't know what you mean by first. Can you be specific why you are here? My question was so simple. Why are you here? Are you lost? If you lost, we have rooms here. If somebody is chasing you, we can hide you in your basement.
We know we are in the right address. This is the address that we drew from our home.
So why are you here?
We are here to seek your beautiful first flower hung in marriage.
You're making me talk. Time for me. Okay. You know what? I'll make it simple. I'm going to bring the flowers. If you see your flower, will you be able to identify it?
Oh, yes. Yes. You will.
Trust us.
Okay.
We know now, what we want. We know why we are
here. You said you have your nephew David, or who? Who is David?
My good friend David.
Your good friend David?
Yes.
And where is David?
You let us see the flower and we'll bring David.
No, David, no flower.
I think that is not fair. It is not fair in the sense that you represent your flower, who is equally not here.
I was about to bring the flowers, but it's going to take me 5 days to complete this assignment. I said, number one, David send you. You don't even know the flowers yourself.
Oh, we do.
No, you don't. Because I've been asking you which are the flowers. You've not been able to mention the flowers. You keep telling me first flower. Okay. You don't have first flower in this house.
Okay. I think.
Then, if your David is here, it will be simpler.
Okay. For David, the firstborn of Mr. William Waltz.
Oh my God, you've already been fined. Please, you've been fined. You did already in our house to know who firstborn is, whether it's a male or female. Are you looking for a male firstborn?
A female firstborn.
You said firstborn.
Female. I stand to be corrected. Female.
The female is not firstborn.
May I ask a question?
Yes.
Are you asking for name? Because if you are asking for name, then you have to rephrase your question so we would understand.
I asked you why you were here. You said you were here to pluck a flower. What flower? A lily flower, all the adjectives that can be described. Fine, we love it. But that is not convincing. Before we can show you any flower, the bottom line is we have to see who wants to pluck the flower, because the person plucking the flower is the one going to take care of the flower, not you. If you don't see the person plucking the flower, there will be no flower. Is that so difficult to understand?
No, it's not, but it looks like you are distancing the spokesperson from the person we speak for. And kindly address that so we can move forward, because we speak for David. We represent David. So anything that we say here is coming directly from David. With the greatest respect.
Understand. Where is David?
Thank you.
Okay. We're going to bring David.
Thank you. Thank you.
Gentlemen, I present to you David.
Oh. Welcome, David, to our humble home. So now we've seen David. We're David, right?
Yes.
Young man, are you David?
Yes. You okay. Speak through us. Yes, David.
David. David, what?
David Victor. If you want to hear it properly, I will allow that.
Give it to me.
Vituli.
Vituli.
Please, can we give it? Come on. Give him a hand of applause.
All right, so let me recount. You said earlier you were here to pluck a flower. What have you brought to pluck the flower? Because you can't pluck the flowers here. They are thorny. So you can't pluck them with your hand. You don't have medics here to treat anything. What have you brought here to pluck the flowers, please?
What exactly are you looking for?
Oh, you coming to my home to pluck a flower and you're asking me what I'm looking for? When you go and pluck a flower, what do you use to pluck a flower?
Diamond. My tools.
Okay, so where are your tools?
Right before you.
I don't see anything.
We have a snap. Like the costume goes. We have a snap. We all know we don't do this with colored drink, but a clean one so that. You can. You see that, right?
Can I have it, please?
Oh, yeah, sure.
How many did you bring?
Two.
You couldn't bring three?
No, two.
The tradition goes, you always bring two. Bring two.
You can always go about tradition and add one more.
No, two.
It's two, bring two.
Okay.
Yeah, you asked for two, so we brought two. Okay.
At this point,
You don't sit down.
Okay.
You start coming to pour the flower after
Okay.
At this point, I would like to introduce to you members of my home. Then after I've introduced to you the members of my home, I will ask my uncle, who is the owner of this home, if this now should be accepted. I'm not accepting it now, I'm holding it. So I'm going to introduce to you members of my home. Then if he accepts it, then we will ask you to introduce yourselves to know who you are here. Maybe one of you may be a terrorist with some bomb inside his pocket, we don't even know. So we want to know all of you before we move on to do anything next. All right. I'm going to make it easy. Going to start from my right side, give the mic to the person will mention her name, introduce herself, him or herself, and then we move forward. So let's start from sister here. My sister, auntie.
My name is Eraba. I'm Eraba, one of the members of the family.
Thank you.
I'm Teresa. I'm the one of the family.
I'm Fosua, the mother of the bride.
What bride?
The mother of the family.
Hello. I'm King David. Okay? The father and the father of my man. Okay?
Awesome.
William Wallace. The father of the bride.
We don't have the right. The father of the flower.
I am Jackie, a member of the family.
I'm Monica, member of the family.
I'm Daddy. My.
I'm Ken, I'm a flower friend.
I'm Kenny.
I'm Cynthia, a member of the family.
I'm Kukwa, member of the family.
I am Marlene, member of the family.
Eunice, member of the family.
And our MC is here, and his back up is here. We have our video excellent man is here. So that is the family members that you've seen over here. All right. So, if you take the opportunity to introduce
King
yourself,
David,
please. Yes, it's King David.
King David.
That's correct. We have also King David in your family, so we have two King Davids. Yeah. Okay, no, Major King David is here.
Oh, okay, two King Davids.
Yeah.
Okay.
He's also original.
So, we'll introduce yourself.
I am Helen, mother of the David coming to the house.
Nice to meet you.
Next one.
Yeah.
I am Nick West, a brother of the David that's been brought to the house.
I'm Ian.
I'm Kelly.
Nice to meet you.
I'm Tomas, good friend of the David.
Thank you.
I'm Johnny, brother of David.
Oh, good.
Benjamin, David is my brother.
Thank you.
Otto Brown, spokesperson of King David. Original.
Okay. So at this point, I'm going to consult with my uncle and see if this house was full accepted. That's good. person who had planted a flower, and he said, we have to add the flower if it has to, if the flower wants to be plucked. If not, you go away. But word of caution, this drink that you brought, whether you pluck or you don't pluck, it doesn't go back to you. You are aware of that. Yeah. You better be aware of that. Okay. I don't know what are these things here too. There are things that you are coming to use for the flower, right? Again, nothing here goes back. If either you plug or not plug, this is how you feel. Right. So we're going to bring the flower, okay? Then, David, if you see the flower you want to plug, will you be able to plug, see the flower? Will you be able to identify the flower?
Yes.
Yes? Okay. You said yes. Good. The flower is in Virginia. I have to go by air. Unless you want to go and come another time. If you want to put the flower today, I have to go by air. You know what it means? Okay.
Okay, so what are you asking for?
Oh, come on, family, Dave. This is United States of America. Come on. I have to go by a plane ticket.
Plane ticket?
Yes.
Plane ticket.
Plane fare, please. You buy the ticket.
Actually, one of David's friends works at Booking.
Good. That makes it easy. Yeah.
Yes. And even David, David can even arrange for a private jet.
Yes.
So,
that'd be great.
You know.
I'm fine.
You don't worry. We'll send for the flower. So what do you want?
Plain fair.
Plain fair.
Fair. Fair, fair, fair.
You gotta open your wallet.
I understand that. So what are you talking about? I mean,
dollars to buy ticket to go bring the flower.
Oh. I got you.
Thank you.
Oh, my sister,
how to? So, right?
So, Mama said you should.
Thank you. This is what I was, all that I'm asking. Let me make it quick, okay? I won't wait. Thank
I'm carrying,
David, we're here once again with the flower that you asked for.
Hello.
Yes. So we brought you the flower. What next?
Can we see?
You want to see what?
The flower.
Oh, okay. No, no problem. David, is that the flower you asked for? Seriously?
Glasses on, okay. So I need money to buy a new glasses.
And in addition, we need another money for
yes, for the
play because that one is gone. You see, that is this brings me back to the beginning when you came here. I asked you specifically what you're looking for. In another plane fair, please.
So, this one is your knock. The first one you asked for.
Yeah.
And this one is for the plane fair that, you know, you have misused. So, 12 loaves.
12 loaves.
But what is the guarantee that we are going to see the flower? This beautiful flower we're talking about. I mean, this flower is beautiful. That's a princess right here.
We are coming back.
But you know,
we are coming back.
I mean,
you see, when you were entering, I asked you,
yes.
You were tip for the gate man.
Yes.
If you were giving the gate man tip, everything would have been solved long time.
Oh.
T-I-P.
Oh,
tip. Okay. It solves everything. It is called protocol.
Plane fare.
So what's the new plane
fare? So what's the new plane fare?
The new plane fare.
Yeah.
I mean,
the Uber is waiting for me, my
dear. Brothers and sisters. Would you talk to this man to me?
Hello,
sir.
Tell this man, she said everything here is beautiful.
So, your tip?
Monsieur Slim Fair?
Yes.
The new
plane? Plus the new plane fare. It's all in.
This man.
Everything is in there. Don't open it. Don't open it.
It's not yours.
Before you said misuse plane fare, now it's misuse and the new plane fare. Come on.
So, I mean, we appreciate Princess.
You know what?
You know.
Let me try my luck again. I'm going to try again. I cannot assure you, but let me try. All right. I'm going to go and try again to bring another flower, because we have plenty of flowers in this house. All of them blossom and very beautiful. And ready to be plucked, I told you. So I'm not trying to be difficult or anything. All right. So let's try it one more time. All right?
Okay.
We are very grateful.
I'm on a belly, then no they see me. I'm on a belly, then no they see me. I'm on a belly, then no they see me. I'm on a belly, then no they see me. Sorry for who won't be my partner. Sorry, I'm only human. You must be nobody. I'm
Thank you. We're still here. We haven't gone anywhere. I was sent to go and bring a flower, and I brought the flower. This time, I don't think there's any mistake you guys when you send me back again. David, Dave, I'm going to ask you and your family again. My sister here, is it the flower you are here to pluck?
Yes.
You haven't even seen a face and you are yes? Seriously?
It's smelly. It's smelly.
Let me come in here. Just by the way she's dressed, we can say yes. So yes. We don't need to see the face now. Yes.
I'm going to go to Mr. Reverend Kodjo. We are a very hospitable family. At the same time, we are a very serious family. If you see my sister's face, you cannot say no. Yes is yes. You cannot have a second flower. You said just by addressing, you have said yes. So after seeing the face, you can change your mind. I hope you accept that.
Yes.
Yes.
Let's go ahead. That was a good guess. That was a dangerous one, though. It was dangerous, but it was a good guess. All right.
Beautiful.
So let me go for consultation again. Manera. I'm the spokesperson for Uwapa. I am Mr. William Wallace. If you are here, you are a branch of your opening day. Vittori, on your neighbor, Shapo, Waba. Let me speak English so that you can all understand.
Yeah, I was just about to say we cannot participate in what you are talking about.
I was actually not addressing you, I was addressing
you. You are right.
Yeah, so.
You have every right to speak.
Thank you.
Your language.
Mm-hmm. Now, Osadel.
For the sake of the people here,
speak English. Yeah. So, I mean, I was speaking on behalf of your dad. He said, the family on my right hand here, mm-hmm. the family of gentlemen standing over there. Do you know him?
Yes, I do.
Awesome. What is his name?
David Vituli.
Very good. So David Vituli is here with his family to ask for your hand in marriage. That is why we are here today. And your dad has asked me to consult with you. They brought a schnapp as an introductory tradition for the marriage. And he's asking me to ask you if the family should accept everything that they brought.
Yes, please do.
Thank you.
I'm going to ask you for the second time. Maame Manan, I'm speaking on behalf of your dad.
Yes.
That the gentleman, David Vituli.
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 See, she knows everything.
Vituli is here for the family to ask for your hand in marriage.
Yes.
And your dad is asking if you agree to this marriage.
Mapocho, yes.
Awesome. Amen. I'm going to ask you for the third time, and that is going to be the last time.
Okay.
Breathe very well. Let the blood circulate very well in your brains. And answer with honesty. Your dad is asking you that the gentleman, David Vituli, is here with his family to ask for your hand in marriage. They brought drinks. They brought some stuff here. And he's asking if we should accept them. And are you prepared and ready to marry him?
Yes.
Clap for him.
Oh, awesome. Woo!
Quand est-ce que c'est un frère? Yeah,
yeah.
C'est un frère?
Yeah, yeah.
So, this is the Honor Brazil Busian of Cape Coast.
Yeah.
In New Jersey here.
New
so
New
when
York.
I say Connor, New York, I live in New Jersey.
I did not hear David's family say Yembra. I want to hear that.
I'm going to teach them.
Wait. This one only came from here.
Wait. It was you. Who said he can speak English?
Oh, of course I did.
So why are you taking us back to...
Oh, no.
Let's go.
Would you let me know that it's just a response? Okay.
Yeah, but we have
you
to...
You know, I mean, why is he taking us back there? Speak English so we can understand.
So you guys don't. But you haven't
get
a woman yet. So humble.
Oh.
Okay,
I was about to say exactly what my auntie said. Like,
yeah, when we see a threat like that,
you are here to pluck flowers. We have not even given you the flowers yet, and you started some exchanges of words with us. And you need to humble yourself and let us have the day, okay? For today is ours.
Okay,
let's have the day.
We accept.
Well,
it's not easy to come and pluck a flower that we've been...
No, that's fine.
It's not easy to come and pluck somebody's flower that we've been watering it for so many years and just giving it away to you just so easily like that. So we are also going through some emotional stuff here, so please plead with that and then just exercise patience with us.
Okay.
Alright. So like I said earlier, this is Connor Abazibuzian of Cape Coast. And there is this saying that we do to request for a response. So when I say one free year, it means we are calling for goodness to come our way. Then the response should be, yes, goodness should come. That's all. Okay. So when I say one free year, it means goodness should come our way. Then the response is, yimra, means goodness should come. That's all. There's nothing in it.
That's all I was asking.
So, the Ebusiapeni, I don't know what you know what is Ebusiapeni, is the leader of the whole, the house, head of the household. First, Maame Mana here, father is a twin. And whenever twins come, they don't come out together. Especially the women here know very well. Okay? They don't come out together. One come first, and another one come second. And that is called twin. Okay? So he's a twin. And his twin brother is David, King David right here. And he is William David and William, they are twins. So Maame Mana has two fathers.
Two fathers, yes.
So he is so much, it appeals so much to him about this quote that we do, quotation. So all what he's saying is that since you are coming to the family, he wants to get the same response from you. Yimra. So what he's saying is that when I say Konegusia, one free ye, you all together with us should respond Yimra. That's all what he's asking for. So we're going to say it again. Konegusia one free ye.
Yimra.
Konegusia one free ye. So over to you, Julati. What have you brought to brought this flower out of this household?
Well, we have received your response. She said she agreed. So what is the question? What do you demand from us? What we have to do to actually get in?
All right. To get in, number one, she comes from a household with the father and the mother to show appreciation to the parents. But that before then, in this household, it's a religious household. So when you come in, we want the child, my sister, to go to a family who believe in the same religion. And our religion is the Bible. So first and foremost, you do bring the Bible.
Yes, you bring the Bible. You have the Bible here.
You have the Bible.
Yes, we do. We also brought with us ring.
What is it for? You came with a ring. Oh, okay. Okay. Hold on with your ring. Okay. Did you bring something for the parent? The father?
Yes.
What do you have for the father?
This is the gift for the father. The cloth.
Like I told you, nothing here goes back whether we give you the flower or not. Remember, I told you earlier on.
We agree.
That is our tradition. Nothing goes back to you.
We agree.
Okay. Is there anything for the mother too?
Yes.
Yes. This is also for the mother.
Oh, very beautiful.
Very beautiful.
Thank you.
Yes.
Very beautiful. You guys are
very respectful. We are prepared. We have to go home with this.
The most important one. You can put that forward. That one should be the heaviest parcel.
It is heavy.
And we are from a very large family.
It is heavy.
So many siblings, cousins. That we are many.
It's a fact check.
Yeah. So you have something for the brothers and sisters. That's the most important one.
Yes, please.
If you don't want us to be knocking on your door every day in the morning.
So this envelope is for the brothers and sisters.
That one I will hold it. I'm the senior one. I hold it.
You have a senior
brothers and sisters.
Yes. He's the senior one.
I'm the senior one, so I hold it.
Papa.
Papa is the youngest.
He's the oldest.
So older, why do I have to be the youngest?
Please, I want to make a comment.
Okay.
This money, Papa, listen carefully. It is not just for you to spend. It is to charge you to keep an eye on your sister.
Yes.
If anybody crossed the line, you have to make sure she's protected and that person goes away. So you protect your sister's marriage. You understand?
Hello.
That's the reason why we are giving you this money. Okay? Thank you.
All right. Now, the main part of the event. What have you brought to plug, to plug the flower?
Everything on the floor before you.
Oh, wow.
The sweet, suitcase, the drinks.
Mm-hmm.
Cooking utensils.
Mm-hmm.
And I can't even name it. It's a lot. It's a lot. Too much stuff. As a matter of fact, we brought more than you asked for.
Thank you. The ring. I will call on Uncle Kojo to come and pray over the ring for us. And David, you are free to come forward now. To come and stand by you. You can stand by. Maame?
Maame?
You can stand by
David. Maame, come
here. David, stand with Maame.
Now you belong here.
Okay. And Uncle Kojo is going to pray over this ring. And after he has prayed over the ring, he's going to give you, David, I'm talking to you. Uncle Kojo is going to pray over this ring. After he has prayed over the ring, he's going to give you the ring, and you are going to put the ring on my knees. Not the middle finger. Okay. You know what I'm talking about.
Yes.
Very good. Uncle Joe.
Dear God, we ask you to bless this ring. This ring is a symbol. That brings David and Maame together. You put them together because that's what you want. We thank you for your blessings. We thank you for this day. And we know you are here. Therefore, thank you. David. Just drink on my knee.
Anybody taking pictures?
Are you taking?
David, hold it. Let me take one more picture.
Can't even get assist.
Hold on. Hold on. Right there. Good. Nice one. Well done. Guys, give them a clap. Give them a clap. Give them a
clap. Woo! Whatever, car, TV, whatever, you have the money. David and Maame, this is a manual to life. For you and for your wife. And for whoever is coming later in your life. And the Bible is like a bank account. The more you put in, the more you take out. So the more you read the Bible, the more you will be in the Spirit and in the presence of the Lord. So don't put it at the side of your bedroom table and just look at it. Open it and get your instructions to life.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank
you. At this point, we will ask Uncle Joe for another prayer to end this ceremony.
male and female, in your image. Look mercifully upon this man and this woman who have come to you seeking your blessing, and assist them with your grace, that with true fidelity and steadfast love, they may honor and keep the promises and vows they make through Jesus Christ, our Savior, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Speak on behalf of my uncle, and First Corinthians chapter 7 verse 10 to 11. He said, Jesus has a word about a marriage. And Jesus wants marriage to be a permanent institution. What does it mean? It means God taking two people, that is man and a woman, to come together, to become one flesh, means that God has joined them together. And what God has joined together, no man should put asunder. And again, God wants marriage to be an institution. So in God's mind, what God wants marriage to be something that everybody can go through and graduate. Just like you go to school, you start from first grade, then you go all the way to 10th grade, you graduate, you go to college, you graduate, then you keep going. Then God will give you a certificate of graduation. God don't want dropouts in marriage. It is not God's wish that there should be dropouts. And also, as an institution, God wants to keep it and preserve it. He wants man to preserve it. Just assume you have a government which comes to power and says that, oh, I'm not going to fund education, so everybody should stay home and break down education. What will happen to this world? Nobody wants it. Institutions are there to help us. It is there for our progress. It is there for our prosperity. So just like marriage, it is an institution God has established. So, Maame, Dave, as you join this God institution called marriage, my wish for you is to keep it safe. Preserve it. Let it progress. God has bound the two of you together for life. So stay together for life. Graduate from this God institution. Get your certificate, and heaven will rejoice. Amen.
Listen to each other and be happy. That's very important. And communication. Yes, listen to each other.
Anybody want to have a word of advice? Anybody?
It's unfortunate that I took the lead before you. I'll say that in the marriage, there is a lot of patches that you have to make it up, especially when you go to live together. But be patient with each other. Husband, the scripture says, love your wife. For all you know, she might not even need anything from you. All she needs is love. And trust me, once you are able to do that, all the rest will follow. Woman, submit to your husband. We are in a world where everything is, I have the right, I'm the woman. Yes, please submit to your husband. It's a lot of things involved in it when being submitted, even when they have really, really rubbed you wrong, but you just have to obey and submit. And let the love rule no matter what. Keep it going. And this I leave with you.
Oh, okay.
Maame and David.
Give me a word.
He says, therefore shall a man leave his wife and his mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. I like the version that says, therefore shall a man leave his wife and his father and his mother and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall become one flesh. You are one flesh now, a new family. Mom and dad, please keep your distance. When they have misunderstanding and mommy comes home, send her back. When David also walk out of the house and mommy, he comes to you, send him back. They have to fix it. And David, please, my daughter says something that you have to submit. My mommy has to submit. Please, love her to submit. Love her to submit. For a woman to submit, you have to love her. Women just don't submit. Love her to submit. This is my word of advice to the two of you. Thank you.
Hi, Mommy and David. I just want to say that you just have to love each other. That's the most important thing. And you have to do what you do best. Support each other. And when the children come, you have to love them. And let them make their own decisions. And love yourselves, because the children will go like you. You're living home now. You still have, it's gonna be you and David. So as much as you want to protect the children, let them also make their own choices, because by the end of the day, it's gonna be you and David. So love him, support his dreams, and let him support yours. At the moment, you guys live far away. We'll miss you. There is no home here, so you're not coming back. You are on your own. So love, David. David, we really love you. And as a family, we are happy to have you as a family. And we are Europeans, you and I, now, and Maame, so we can, you can come back home and anytime you want to come to London. And we love you.
Okay, hi. My advice is short and sweet. It's called double duvets. You can each have a blanket and then you don't have to, you know, cut. Yes. No, but really, just enjoy the journey and, you know, enjoy the evolution and how you guys grow into becoming and always come back together.
Uncle P should say something.
With my wife, when we first heard that David has engaged you and wants to marry you, and we said, wow, Maame have come a long way. And Maame has shown a lot of resilience throughout his growing up, you know. As kids, sometimes they have their own thing going, but in good time they come back. And Maame has shown all those, you know, principles in his growing. And really, I'm so delighted to be the uncle and to be sitting here to witness the event that took place today. So one day, I can tell my grandkids, listen, Maame did it. With all the obstacles in her path, he was able to do it. And she did it so successfully. Maame, you have brought us honor and grace to this family. David, you have shown a lot of love for you to enter this house. Like my uncle said, he said, this house is not a very easy house to walk into. When you are coming here, you have to be fully prepared to come to this house. Because in this house, we demand. We don't ask. We demand. So to make a long story short, I'm advising the two of you to stay together in the name of the Father. Stay together in the name of your love between the two of you. Because someone said a long time ago, what is love? People say that, you know, love is not real. People have said so many things about love and the way they define it. But I take one definition from one person, this is a long fellow. He said, you know, love is like a candle. Like you go to the Catholic Church on the altar, they have a candle. It burns, but it never dies. I love that definition. So I want you to leave this moment when you leave here. Cherish it, the word love. That it burns, but then never dies, okay? And keep it within you, because you are going to make it. This house is blessed, the family is blessed, you are blessed. There's nothing that can evade you in this universe. You've done it. So we ask the Almighty Father to guide you in all your ways, okay? Because this is the day that the Lord has given to us. Let us be glad in it and rejoice. Thank you.
Thank you. Anybody else?
William.
As I said earlier yesterday, I said my children don't seek advice. They don't. But each time they sought my help. They already made up their mind. I think from this time on, if you seek my advice, whether or not you like it or not. Thank you.
I don't know if you fall. Today, you are part of the family.
Maame, you too. I'm speaking to you today. Let me tell you, both of you, marriage is a serious business. It's not a great chicken thing. It's a serious business. A serious business, there's investment in it. How do you get investment on whatever you invested? It's a seriousness. So don't go and play chicken. Be serious. Trust each other. Mommy, go and trust your husband fully. David, trust Mommy. And everything will come out beautiful. That's all I can give you to go.
Right.
Go and live peacefully and successfully. Create the children. Train them to be as you are, or even better than you, Maame. You see, let us come here and go back and say, oh, this is a successful man. You're going to be successful, David. Maame, you too. Give you all the best. Amos, that's my name.
About life, about marriage, about everything. Now in Proverbs 19, verse 14, it says that a prudent wife is from the Lord. So, David, pray to the Lord that your wife becomes a good one for you, so that you have a long life. Because trust me, if there's a problem at home, you won't be happy. The same goes to you, Maame. Now, this one is an interesting one. This one is from Proverbs chapter 30, verse 19. It says that the way of an eagle is in the air. The eagle flies. The way of a serpent is on the rock. We all know how snakes are, they're on the rock. The way of a ship in the midst of the sea. And the way of a man with a virgin. So David, I'm saying to you, Elmarie, don't use sex as a weapon. Don't weaponize sex. Maame, anytime David wants it. That's what the Bible is saying. I'm not saying this. I'm not saying it. It's the Bible. The last one is Proverbs 5, verse 19. Says that as a loving deer and a graceful doe, let her breast satisfy you at all times. That's what the Bible is saying. It's saying that don't look outside. That's all you got. Let her breast satisfy you. And the last one says, and always be enraptured with her love. And you know, love is not a feeling. Love is something that you do. Love is a law. So, to all the married people here, love is not a feeling. Love is something that you do. So you love each other. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
baby, come to me, oh.
I broke down my business. I'm a shadow, you go right. All I care for the night. Happiness. I broke down my business. me. If you want to take I'm serious, I do talk speak. No fit to rest, I'm on a different frequency. I be down with somebody that can do like me. When I be like Musala, come here with the right wing. I can't do your thing, you know. If you don't get money past you, if you don't get money past you.
Thank you.
Pick one. Sister Gifty, may you please stand up, please? This is my beautiful sister Gifty here. Gifty, go with the word gift. Gifty, gift. So if by chance you brought any gift to the bride and the groom to be, please see Sister Gifty right here. Gifty goes with gift. So if you have any present to be given to them, see my beautiful sister in here. Thank you. Let's keep up with the music, DJ. Great.
I'm I'm gonna go fell. I'm on a delay.
Here, so let's take a breath, please. Yeah. Let's take a breath and welcome the bright and good to be.
Come in, daddy, come in. So you're going to go to doctor's choice soon. So you can show them too.
Make it hey. If you really need
let me show them all. You're saying me. I am saying me. Show them. Maame is your 10, show them. Maame is your 10, show them. Show them. Show them. Maame is your 10, show them.
I want to say,
everybody, yeah, yeah.
I had a beautiful mind.